Good afternoon. And good afternoon.
Yay.
Good that's another one. Welcome to... Thank you. Welcome to a special Father's Day edition of Rooftop, almost Rooftop, Trombone in the Age of COVID-19. Rooftop Trombone in the Age of COVID-19. We are on day number 96. Day number 96, that's how long? Hi, my name is Don Bowyer. I am the Dean of the School of Arts at Sunway University.
I'm going to turn on this microphone so everybody local can hear me. I'm the Dean of the School of Arts at Sunway University, which is just right over there, a couple hundred meters. Really close if you're American and don't know meters. Sunway University in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, in Sunway City, which is a neighborhood within the greater KL, or as we call it, Kuala Lumpur region. And Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia has been on a total national lockdown for 96 days. I say total, that's not quite true anymore. It was a total lockdown for 7 weeks, followed by a partial lockdown for 5 weeks, and then an even less partial lockdown for the last week and almost 2 weeks. We're now in what's called a recovery movement control order. And if you've been following these, which is only about three of you, you know that a month ago on Mother's Day, I came down from my rooftop to do a live show for the residents of the Palmville condominium. Yay, Palmville! Woo! They don't cheer. I need a drummer. Anyway, came down to the courtyard for Mother's Day, and they asked me to come and do it again today for Father's Day. Normally, I play about 15 minutes. Today might go as long as an hour, but I promise not to go past dark because, you know, I have to go to bed. We're going to play a couple of new tunes and also pull out some of the previous tunes I've done because it's a lot to prepare every day. Three tunes a day is about my max. This first one, though, is one of the new ones. And it's for Daddy. It's for everybody's Daddy because it's Father's Day in Malaysia and in many other countries, including in the United States. Happy Father's Day. And this is an old Cole Porter tune that a lot of people have recorded over the years. It's called My Heart Belongs to Daddy. If you look on Google and the only version you find is the Marilyn Monroe one, just keep scrolling. Look for a different one because she doesn't really sing. She just sort of does a Lolita thing. Anyway, Ella Fitzgerald has a wonderful recording. It's been recorded dozens and dozens of times. Anyway, this is none of those versions. Instead of a karaoke file, I created a backing track for this one in a sort of Cuban salsa style, which I thought would be fun because it's different. So My Heart Belongs to Daddy.
Ha 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 ha.
People are scattered, if you can't see them, scattered around the courtyard. It's a rather large courtyard, in fact, a very luxurious courtyard. I don't know if there are any apartments available in Palmville Condominium, but if there are, you should jump on it. It's a great place to be. Anyway, I'm going to continue with one more daddy song, because I don't know if I can even be seen over there. Sorry, you heard me, but you didn't see me. I'm going to continue with one more daddy song. This one is a bit more, it's not more obscure than that, actually. It's, you know, Cole Porter wasn't obscure at one time, but he is now. Anyway, this one was by The Temptations. Does anybody remember Papa Was a Rolling Stone?
Yeah.
And you may or may not, you probably remember the chorus. You may or may not remember that there was a really long instrumental introduction. Because I like you guys, I removed most of that instrumental introduction because I don't think you want to hear me play trombone for like 7 minutes before the melody even starts. So here is Papa Was a Rolling Stone, my version.
Ha 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 ha
Thank you. Papa was nothing if not a Rolling Stone. Okay, I know you want to hear some more upbeat, danceable kind of music today, and some of it modern even, although this one, this next one's not so modern. I think it's probably 30 years old, but that's modern to me, right? This next one is something I did, two or three seasons ago. It seems like about a year and a half ago. Is that when we started this rooftop thing? Anyway, it's a, actually it was a Marvin Gaye recording, but it's, it was recorded a few years ago by David Bowie and Mick Jagger, and it's called Dancing in the Street.
Thank you.
dancing in the courtyard. Who was dancing on that? Anybody? Was anybody dancing?
Yes, I was.
Speaking of David Bowie, another tune I did several weeks ago, or several months ago, it feels like, was a David Bowie tune. Actually, I did a whole set of David Bowie, but I'm going to do one of those again today, and it's called Space Oddity. And somebody asked me today why I was doing this one again, and I said, because it was fun to play. Thank you. Thank you. That's another long fade out, which is hard to do on the trombone live. But that one, in fact, fades out into a sound effect. So anyway, that's Space Oddity by David Bowie. And Earth, Wind & Fire. Do we have any Earth, Wind & Fire fans here?
Yay!
Or out here? We have September by Earth, Wind & Fire. And then you're next. September, Earth, Wind & Fire, September. It's Father's Day, by the way. Have I mentioned that today? It's Father's Day. Happy Father's Day. I'm not sure how much trombone you want to hear. Thank you. That goes on for about another minute and a half, by the way.
Do you have the lyrics?
The lyrics for the one you're going to sing on the screen, yeah.
Ready to play?
We're going to have a couple of guests here today. And in the interest of safe... turn this a little bit. Sorry, this part. In the interest of safe singing, we're going to change out the mask covering the microphone. Ooh. Let's just turn that down for a second. Talk among yourselves. I think we've got it here. You're going to be over here? Move this to where you are. How's that? A little too high still. Sure? Okay. All right. So.
I can't think about it.
Lyrics. Okay. Let's see. Tell everybody your name. Introduce yourself.
Hi, my name's Aaron. I'm 15 years old this year, and I play the French horn.
Aaron, the horn player, 15 years old, lives upstairs somewhere in this building, I believe.
Hi, and I'm Patty, and I'm 17 years old, and I live in this building.
Upstairs in this building. Anybody else want to join us? Anybody from the B block?
On behalf of the management committee, I would like to introduce to you our chairman, Mr. Goh, and thank you for making this wonderful Palmville condominium a condominium that's alive, and we partake in whatever activities we could and entertain all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You want to introduce the song? Oh, or you want me to?
I'm Patricia Tan, and I live here.
Are you visible? You're visible. Okay. You're not visible. You want to get over here? Here, I'll move out of the way.
And I live one layer before dawn. Yeah.
They know what I look like. You get over there.
And I'm accompanied by a very handsome guy who is 16 years old.
15?
15. And I'm 16.
But he'll be 16 soon.
And Don 17.
Did you already say it's so long? Did you already say the title?
Yeah, and together with Don and myself and what's your name?
Aaron,
we're gonna sing and play For the Longest Time by Billy Joel.
Yeah. And did you get this?
And if you know the song,
A,
come on, guys.
Then A, then B, then C, then B, yeah. Then C, then it's, A. It's
all that. Yeah. We're gonna dedicate this to the Ministry of Home Affairs for the longest time.
Longest time. Okay, here we go. I may have muted. Let's start that again because I may have muted the computer on that last tune, huh? All right. Turn the computer back up.
If you know how to click, click with me.
Go.
Dum dum dum.
For the longest time.
COVID-19 for the longest time. Thank you, guys.
Great job. Thank you, Patty. Thank you, Aaron. Thank you so much. Thank you. And I'm not sure what's next. I'll let Patty keep her, in case she wants to sing again. I seem to have lost mine, though. Oh, well.
It flew right into the flowers, huh?
Oh, we'll have to pick that up later. We don't want to litter with these things. So, good afternoon again. We are about halfway through, maybe a little over halfway. Let's see, I normally when I do these shows, I don't know how many of you have seen this before. Oh, sorry. If I had a sound engineer, but sadly she's 15,000 miles away. If you've seen these before, you know I whine sometimes about the fact that my wife is trapped halfway around the world. Her name is Donna, by the way. She gets mad when I just say my wife. She tells me I have a name, you know. Anyway, sorry, struggling with this. Anyway, so I have no sound engineer, so it's just me, but that's okay. I'm having fun. I hope you're having fun. Thank you for being here today. I'm gonna do, this is another tune that I discovered several weeks ago as a request for a little girl who is my niece on her, I want to say 10th birthday, but I'm afraid I'll be wrong and she'll get mad at me. But anyway, a niece of mine had a birthday. Actually, her brother, who's a year older, has the exact same birthday. They both had a birthday on the same day sometime in the past. And they asked me to do a piece from the Broadway musical called Hamilton, which I don't think has made it to Malaysia yet, but I do think a lot of people in Malaysia are familiar with it. I don't know. Anyway, it's... for a couple of years, it was the most hot ticket on Broadway, and of course they're closed down now. But it's a musical in a rap, mostly in a rap style. Probably 75-80% of the music in the musical is rap, hip hop music, if you will. When she asked, actually it was my brother relayed that request to me. I said, you know, I'm not sure I can play rap on the trombone, but for grace, I decided to try it and. It was fun. I enjoyed it. I'm going to play some of the things that they rap. You won't hear the words, of course. By the way, it's a historical drama that deals both with the history of the United States, but more importantly with race relations in the United States. And of course, it's been around for 3 years now or so. It's not like it's a new reaction to what's going on now. But another thing I really like about this is the title of this song is Battle of Yorktown, and it's about a battle during what Americans call the Revolutionary War, what British call the that little uprising in across the water. Anyway, in the late 1700s, in that war, the Battle of Yorktown, and that's the title of this, but there is a subtitle, and the subtitle is so appropriate for the last 3 months, for my year and a half that we've been under lockdown, it seems like, and that subtitle is The World Turned Upside Down. I feel like our world is, in fact, upside down. Here's the Battle of Yorktown from Hamilton.
The Battle of Yorktown, 1781. The
The world turned upside down, or the Battle of Yorktown from Hamilton. Hope you enjoyed that. I want to slow things down and do another fairly modern tune. And you're going to play ukulele on this one, aren't you? Excellent. We're going to have Patty come back and play ukulele on this one. On Mother's Day, I did a beautiful tune called Señorita by Camila Cabella, or Cabeja, and I thought for Father's Day I'd do another one of her tunes, and it's called Havana. Hope you like it. You set?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Sanitizer?
Ah.
Havana. Thank you, Patty. Thank you so much, Patty, on the ukulele.
Head on.
Not
a little.
Oh, now I can't play trombone.
Oh.
Okay, we have next. I have as many as four tunes left. I was, depending on what time, oh, it's getting late. We may cut that some, because I don't want to keep anybody awake. But the next one, move this back up here. The next one is, if the sound guy could just turn that down a little. Okay, this next one is a tune that I'm sure all of you know. Some of you knew it even before the movie came out. It's called Bohemian Rhapsody by Queen. And I did this a few weeks ago, and I thought, you know, I need to try this again because there's a lot of different parts I'm trying to play. I want a second shot at it. So, hope you enjoy Bohemian Rhapsody. Go.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. Yeah.
More or less. Thank you. I thought for fun, after doing all of these tunes that you probably know, I'd do an original composition of mine. This is something I wrote for a big band with a lot of trumpets and trombones and saxophones, but I've simplified it, hopefully, and it involves me singing, although I don't sing so much as shout. You'll hear it. Anyway, it also involves you joining me. There's nobody behind me anymore. It involves you guys joining me for the chorus, which is very simple. The name of the song is Itchin' in the Kitchen. And the chorus is, I got the itch, I'm itchin' in the kitchen. Repeat that. I got the itch, I'm itchin' in the kitchen. And then the last line, I got a scratch, 'cause I'm itching in the kitchen. You'll hear it. And it happens something like 5 times in the piece, so you got plenty of chances. I got the itch, I'm itching in the kitchen, same thing again, and then finally, I got the scratch, 'cause I'm itching in the kitchen. I got two scratch, 'cause I'm itching in the kitchen. And then there's also verses that I will sing, which are meant to be amusing. If you don't laugh, it's okay, but if you do, it's better. Anyway, here's Itching in the Kitchen. It's a blues tune. I got a scratch, 'cause I'm in
butter. But if I don't get it, my heart's all a flutter. Life's a dream with soft ice cream. But if I don't get it, I just have to scream. I gotta scratch, cause I'm itching in the kitchen. Life is easy when it's all greasy. But if I don't get it, I feel somewhat queasy. Life is high with pecan pie. But if I don't get it, I just have to cry. I gotta scratch, cause I'm itching in the kitchen. Come on, chorus, everybody. I got the itch. I'm itching in the kitchen. Go ahead, scratch. It feels good, doesn't it? I got the itch. I'm itching in the kitchen.
That's actually more fun when there's four trumpets and four trombones and saxophones, and I don't have to do all that stuff. Anyway, it's fine. Thank you for singing. I heard a little bit. The last one on my definite set list, it was a request to do a medley, an Elton John medley, of two of his best-known tunes. And they are Rocket Man and Crocodile Rock, or as I call it, Crocodile Rock, Crocodile Man, I don't know, call it what you want. Anyway, we're gonna do we've taken the two tunes and mashed them together, including the karaoke even is mashed together. I probably broke 17 or 18 different copyright rules on this. Well, I break that many every day. For which I apologize, I'm sorry. I hope you enjoy this. It's called Rocket Man and then Crocodile Rock, and I gotta get a trombone ready. Okay. I'm
After six. If you want, I can do one more piece. If you don't, I can stop. I'm happy to stop. But the last piece I have prepared is a Bruno Mars tune called Uptown Funk. Do you want to hear that or no? Okay. Uptown Funk it is. Okay. No talking. Let's just go. So much. It's Uptown Funk. Happy Father's Day. And thank you so much. And to all the fathers out there in Facebook world, happy Father's Day to you too. Tomorrow afternoon at 5 p.m. Malaysian time, I'll be back up there on the balcony or the rooftop, and for a much shorter set, because I have absolutely no idea what I'm playing. I got to figure it out tonight, I guess. Anyway, thanks so much. Bye-bye.